I am greater than any Togden. I am greater than any Turton. I am greater than any Turton. I am greater than any Nirmanakaya. I am greater than any Nirmanakaya. I am greater than any Yangtze. I am greater than any Yangtze. I am greater than any Trichen. I am greater than any Trichen. I am greater than any Tripa. I am greater than any Tripa. I am greater than any Lachen. I am greater than any Lachen. I am greater than any Dharma Master. I am greater than any Dharma Master. I am greater than any Yawang. I am greater than any Yawang. I am greater than any Yishin Norbu. I am greater than any Yishin Norbu. I am greater than any Yogini. I am greater than any Yogini. I am greater than any Kumara. I am greater than any Kumara. I am greater than any Bhikkhu. I am greater than any Bhikkhu. I am greater than any Bishop. I am greater than any Bishop. I am greater than any Cardinal. I am greater than any Cardinal. I am greater than any Archbishop. I am greater than any Archbishop. I am greater than any brother. I am greater than any brother. I am greater than any sister. I am greater than any sister. I am greater than any minister. I am greater than any minister. I am greater than any monk. I am greater than any Monsignor. I am greater than any Monsignor. I am greater than any pastor. I am greater than any pastor. I am greater than any priest. I am greater than any priest. I am greater than any patriarch. I am greater than any patriarch. I am greater than any priestess. I am greater than any priestess. I am greater than any matriarch. I am greater than any matriarch. I am greater than any rabbi. I am greater than any rabbi. I am greater than any apostle. I am greater than any apostle. I am greater than any elder. I am greater than any elder. I am greater than any reverend. I am greater than any reverend. I am greater than any pope. I am greater than any pope. I am greater than any shaman. I am greater than any shaman. I am greater than any practitioner. I am greater than any practitioner. I am greater than any seer. I am greater than any seer. I am greater than any revelator. I am greater than any revelator. I am greater than any Amida. I am greater than any Amida. I am greater than any Durga. I am greater than any Durga. I am greater than any Avahuta. I am greater than any Avahuta. I am greater than any mother. I am greater than any mother. I am greater than any prophet. I am greater than any prophet. I am greater than any disciple. I am greater than any disciple. I am greater than any devotee. I am greater than any devotee. I am greater than any mendicant. I am greater than any mendicant. I am greater than any hermit. I am greater than any hermit. I am greater than any pilgrim. I am greater than any pilgrim. I am greater than any mystic. I am greater than any mystic. I am greater than any saint. I am greater than any saint. I am greater than any philosopher. I am greater than any philosopher. I am greater than any theologian. I am greater than any theologian. I am greater than any theology. I am greater than any theology. I am greater than any Paramahamsa. I am greater than any Paramahamsa. I am greater than any Tantric. I am greater than any Tantric. I am greater than any sadhu. I am greater than any sadhu. I am greater than any city. I am greater than any city. I am greater than any sai. I am greater than any sai. I am greater than any Jagat Guru. I am greater than any Jagat Guru. I am greater than any monk. I am greater than any monk. I am greater than any sage. I am greater than any sage. I am greater than any holy one. I am greater than any holy one. I am greater than any avatar. I am greater than any avatara. I am greater than any celestial being. I am greater than any celestial being. I am greater than any cosmic being. I am greater than any cosmic being. I am greater than any heavenly being. I am greater than any heavenly being. I am greater than any sacred one. I am greater than any sacred one. I am greater than any Shankaracharya. I am greater than any Shankaracharya. I am greater than any Magi. I am greater than any Magi. I am greater than any teacher. I am greater than any teacher. I am greater than any ascended master. I am greater than any ascended master. I am greater than any Chohan. I am greater than any Chohan. I am greater than any enlightened being. I am greater than any enlightened being. I am greater than any initiate. I am greater than any initiate. I am greater than any heart. I am greater than any heart. Okay. And I could add, I am greater than any king of heaven. I am greater than any king of heaven. I am greater than any queen of heaven. I am greater than any queen of heaven. I am greater than any soul-infused personality. I am greater than any soul-infused personality. I am greater than any spiritual being. I am greater than any spiritual being. I am greater than any luminous one. I am greater than any luminous one. I am greater than any self-realized being. I am greater than any self-realized being. I am greater than any Lord of the Universe. I am greater than any Lord of the Universe. So, stay in the full stop mode. Mood of repentance, full stop mode. Mood of repentance, full stop mode. We're not trying to calculate. Was this helpful? How much? No calculation. There's a basic faith involved here that we are putting our attention on that, which is very profound. There's a basic faith in that, and so we don't worry about measurements. Calculations preempted. Not digging down to see how much effect is it having. No, we're just maintaining this mood of repentance, full stop mode, in whatever burn there is. And maybe for some there's a lot, maybe for some not so much. I don't know. I've been working on this sort of exercise for a long time, actually. So the burn is not so bad. I'm able to do this, you know, and help others out. And maybe the burn's very severe. Because all of these honorifics, all of this, we say, hey, they're between us and God, you see. They're between us and I am-ness. They're not. They're not. There is no betweenness in I am-ness. So we keep saying, well, this is great. You know, the Pope is great. No, I am greater than the Pope. I am greater than the Pope. And so we're affirming that, hey, the one position that there is greater than all these relative positions that we're imagining. We have to set all this relativism down. So we're just evaporating this continuity fear by getting used to, you know, setting it down. There's only the I am-ness. There's not the Pope-ness. There's not the Cardinal-this. There's not the Mahatma-this. There's just the I am-ness. And everything is it. Let's see if I can pull some help out of it. In short, all conscious sensory perception and all that is unconscious or transcendent, everything is already released in the spaciousness of the now. So any attempt to liberate anything anew is superfluous. It is pointless to try and make effort towards release. So don't try. Don't try. Don't struggle and strive in practice. Don't seek. Don't seek. Don't seek intellectual truth. Don't meditate. Don't meditate. Don't contrive meditation. Don't analyze. Don't analyze. Don't analyze in or after an event. Don't practice. Don't practice. Don't practice the upshot of hope and fear. Don't reject. Don't reject. Don't reject emotional karma. Don't believe. Don't believe. Don't believe in righteous religion. Don't trap yourself. Don't trap yourself. Don't cage in your mind. In the absence of an objective field, everything equalized. In the absence of an objective field, everything is equalized. There is only I am-ness. There's no viewpoint on I am-ness. We don't have the Pope's viewpoint on I am-ness. We don't have a Rishi's viewpoint on I am-ness. We don't have a yogi's viewpoint on I am-ness. We don't have a monk's viewpoint on I am-ness. There is no point of view on I am-ness. So there is no objective field of I am-ness. There's not I am-ness and an objective field of I am-ness. Okay. Don't struggle, don't struggle, don't struggle. So you see, the struggle we know is just our continuity fear. Because actually all of this is very self-evident. So our continuity fear is the only struggle. So we just acknowledge it and say, okay, that's my continuity fear is got the shakes. That's okay. I know it'll settle down in a little while. It's like you have dirt in a glass of water and container. It's just stirred up and it's all swirling about. And you just say, I'm not going to struggle with what's happening in that glass of water. I'll just wait and let the dirt settle. That's no problem. Panning for gold, you pour the water in and you stir the gravel up and the water gradually, you know, takes away. Then you stir it some more, it's all cloudy and the water clarifies again. You stir it some more, you keep doing that. Each time the water gets cloudy, right? Somewhat. Finally, you know, everything's being carried away except the heavier gold. The water clarifies and you see it's just gold is just left. It's like that. So when the water clouds up, don't struggle with it. Don't struggle. Just let it clarify again. Just let it clarify. So we're intentionally trying to, you know, pan for gold here and stir up the mixture. Stir up the gravel mixture, the slurry, whatever you want to call it, the slurry. So it, you know, it gets carried away, progressively gets carried away, leaving just the gold. Now, actually, everything is just the gold. There's nothing but gold. But our continuity fear doesn't allow us to accept this, so. All is supersaturated in the now. All is supersaturated in the now. all supersaturated with nowness. All is supersaturated with nowness. We may not be seeing that yet, but I can certainly feel within my being, as it were, the heart's kind of jumping around like, wow, this is really frightening, alarming. It's like some sort of deep down, it's very alarming. So these exercises are alarming. In some way, we find them quite alarming because our defense, our safety net, our walls, our firewalls, we're taking them down, thinning it out. So the exercises are designed to be alarming, subtly alarming. Not a crusade for being alarmist, but subtly alarming. And then that's why we just have to abide, full stop in the now, full stop in the burn. For me, it's like, alarm, like, did you really say this? People are going to be upset at you, It's like, wow, how can you say that? Blasphemous to say. So there's all that pressure too. But that's really continuity fear. It's just continuity fear. I can add a few. I am greater than any psychic. I am greater than any psychic. I am greater than any medium. I am greater than any medium. I am greater than any channeler. I am greater than any channeler. Stop and the burn, the strain, the stress is there. See, we're used to putting those people between us and I am. And saying, well, the I am is there. I mean, that's where it is. It's not here, it's there. It's there with the psychic or something. No, I am is greater than any psychic. I am greater than any psychic. I say, oh boy, who can I go to? Where I say, yeah, here's the I am. Yeah. Yeah, okay, so you got it and I don't, okay. Can't go anywhere for that. You could flip it around too and do a whole different series. The opposite of all this. I am greater than any poor person. I am greater than any poor person. I am greater than any renunciate. I am greater than any renunciate. And you might be able to think of others too. You know, this is not an exhaustive list, just an idea. Just practice. I am. The I am-ness. I am-ness is greater than any. And you fill it in. I am is greater than any charismatic. I am greater than any charismatic. I am greater than any healer. I am greater than any healer. So try and come up with, you know, your own, what you can focus in your mind. What is it that you feel like that maybe I can say I am is here? And it's not here. It's more here than it is here. And feel safe from I am in that way, you see. It's a defense system. But I am is greater. I am is greater. I am is greater. You can say I am is greater than I am. Because we're always seeking for I am, you see. We're always seeking for I am. So, let us say, one more exercise here. I am cannot be. Okay. I am cannot be. I am cannot be found. I am cannot be found. I am cannot be reached. I am cannot be reached. I am cannot be sought. I am cannot be sought. I am cannot be liberated into. I am cannot be liberated into. I am cannot be released into. I am cannot be released into. I am cannot be developed. I am cannot be developed. I am cannot be seen. I am cannot be seen. I am cannot be grasped. I am cannot be grasped. I am cannot be located. I am cannot be located. I am cannot be objectified. I am cannot be objectified. I am cannot be timed. I am cannot be timed. I am cannot be attained. I am cannot be attained. I am cannot be embraced. I am cannot be embraced. I am cannot be touched. I am cannot be touched. I am cannot be impressed. I am cannot be impressed. I am cannot be depressed. I am cannot be depressed. I am cannot be realized. I am cannot be realized. I am cannot be arrived at. I am cannot be arrived at. I am cannot be stepped into. I am cannot be stepped into. I am cannot be calculated. I am cannot be calculated. I am cannot be purchased. I am cannot be purchased. I am cannot be owned. I am cannot be owned. I am cannot be entered. I am cannot be entered. I am cannot be liberated. I am cannot be liberated. I am cannot be thought. I am cannot be thought. I am cannot be concept. I am cannot be concept. So this is just like medicine. We're taking just like medicine. We're not struggling with trying to figure something out. We're using examples like this to erode, 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 evaporate, evaporate, evaporate. We're not trying to analyze or figure anything out. Just very, very direct hammering. Go through this release practice here from Longchenpa. Very intense practice here. All experience is released here and now in luminous mind. An unreleased event is impossible. Samsara is released in the now, liberated as Alpha Purity. Nirvana is released in the now, liberated as spontaneous perfection. Appearances are released in the now, liberated in their baselessness. Life is released in the now, liberated in its luminous heart. Mental elaboration is released in the now, liberated in its limitlessness. Formlessness is released in the now, liberated as pure potential. Pleasure is released in the now, liberated in its equalized reality. Suffering is released in the now, liberated in the ubiquitous basic expanse. Dispassion is released in the now, liberated in the sky-like Dharmakaya. Purity is released in the now, liberated in its empty authenticity. Impurity is released in the now, liberated in supreme, spacious freedom. The levels and paths are released in the now, liberated in the absence. View and meditation are released in the now, liberated in non-discrimination. Conduct is released in the now, liberated in the all good. The goal is released in the now, liberated in the absence of hope and fear. Samayas are released in the now, liberated in the supreme reality. Recitation is released in the now, liberated in nonverbal expression. Contemplation is released in the now, liberated in the absence of a field of thought. Affirmation and negation are released in the now, liberated in the middle way. Dogmatic belief is released in the now, liberated in absence of any ground. Authenticity is released in the now, liberated in absence of any preconception. Inauthenticity is released in the now, liberated in non-critical bias. Karma is released in the now, liberated in its boundless transparency. Afflictive emotion is released in the now, liberated in thorough disinterest. Karmic proclivity is released in the now, liberated in its groundlessness. Karmic result is released in the now, liberated in the discontinuity of experience. Anecdotal method is already released, liberated in self-sufficiency. Liberated in the vast sky-like expanse of non-dual give and take, catharsis is released in the now. Liberated in non-repression, repression is released in the now. Liberated in sky-like freedom, hanging loosely is released in the now. Liberated by the absence of anything to relax, resting freely is released in the now. Liberated by the absence of anything brought to rest. In short, all conscious sensory perception and all that is unconscious or transcendent, everything is already released in the spaciousness of the now, so any attempt to liberate anything anew is superfluous. It is pointless to try and make effort toward release. It is pointless to try and make effort toward release. So we are not on any crusade of release here. We are simply evaporating the continuity fear, letting it just evaporate. Knowing we have a severe continuity problem. Very severe. This is the ultimate phobia we're working on. So it has to be gentle, determined, and intelligent. Don't rush it. But be determined to do as much as you can. Be determined to do as much as you can. Don't force it. Remember, this is really towards release a phobia, the most incredibly severe phobia there could possibly be. That is, if we drop the stance of an hallucinator, we're afraid we'll cease to exist. This is a phobia. This is something that's irrational. But saying that it's irrational, it doesn't cure the phobia, does it? Like I could have said, hey, my fear. People told me my fear of spiders. They said, hey, that's irrational. Why does everybody be afraid of it? I mean, they try to, like, you know, give you a pep talk. Hey, there's nothing to be afraid of. It doesn't work, does it? Does not work at all. So you cannot merely give a pep talk. Say, hey, drop the stance of hallucination. Come on, you can do it. It's no big deal. Doesn't work. Leads to problems. For sure it leads to severe problems. So we are saying, no, I have a very severe continuity problem here. I'm not trying to throw it all down. I'm trying to evaporate, you see. Evaporate is a gradual thing, right? You're not even aware how much is being evaporated, right? You're watching a glass of water in the sun or, you know, or an ice cube in the sun. It gradually melts, it gradually evaporates, so, you know, just bit by bit by bit. So there's no way to measure, really, You can say ultimately, but as far as spiritual dysphobia, there's no way to really measure it. You know, it's futile to try and foolish to try. It's just in hindsight, we become aware like, hey, what used to be very difficult for me now is actually a piece of cake. So we know progress is being made, but we don't try to interrupt the progress by saying, wait a minute, let me take some measurements, and you can spend your lifetime trying to figure out how to measure this and stop your progress altogether. It's very foolish. And yet here we are as a society waiting for computation to be all powerful in the world, as if then our fear will somehow disappear. We say, well, I know exactly how much progress I made today. What they really want is to figure out how not to make progress. And so their desire to compute progress is really so then they can say, okay, I'm going to avoid that at all costs. I can measure my non-progress. That is really what the world wants, which is why they've invited all this high technology in here. As I've said, they think help is to be reassured that they can't be helped, cannot be helped, cannot be helped. They think help is to be reassured that they cannot be helped. So they want computation of help so they can make sure that they can avoid it. They can know, oh, this is registering as help because this computer is help. Okay, I don't want that. Let's get rid of that. So it's a very tricky situation here in the world, isn't it? Just as, like I said, the idea of getting closer to God also means a farther awayness, you see. So our fear has all these tricks. And we think, oh, we're being helped. We're going to know what our progress and be able to detail and delineate it, measure it, compute it, objectify it. That's what we're really after. We're really after more spiritual progress. We want to just be able to, you know, hook our brains up and know exactly how much we're making and if we can really do it. But beneath that, they really are trying to figure out, is there some way to be aware of spiritual progress so we can avoid it altogether? We can avoid it all together. This is the goal of the world. So hearing this can probably releases a lot of confusion for you. It certainly has for me. It's like, wow, that's why it's so difficult here. That's why it's so confusing. That's why I'm so baffled. Wow. That's why helping usually doesn't work. You know, get this backlash. And that's why it gets weird. That's why it gets confusing. Now I know. Wow. They only want to be helped so they can figure out what is help like so then they can avoid it. That is the truth. That's the unrepentant spirit is like that. Now the repentant spirit says, hey, I'm really struggling because of my continuity fears. So this is tough, it's difficult. But I'll keep, you know, plodding along here. Keep trying. Thanks for the help, but my continuity fear is kicking up and I'm saying, wow, this is a little difficult. Yeah, I'm feeling a little too much strain. Let me just full stop in the now. Go into full stop mode here. In a little while, I think maybe I'll be able to, you know, do some more. See, that's the repentant spirit. The spirit that's repentant is like that. This is very heavy information to hear this. This came to me yesterday. And I have to sleep on this. Wow. You know, most people that want to help, they feel, you know what? I get this sneaky feeling that people don't really want to be helped. Like, I feel like I've really not been able to help here. This feeling like something's wrong here. What is it? My whole life I've been trying to figure this out. Never in my wildest dreams did I think that that people, the help they want is to render you incapable of helping them. I never, you know, it's like somebody who's out in a, got swept up by a riptide and they're way out to the ocean and they're drowning. They're, help, help, I'm drowning. It's floundering around and someone swims out to save them. And what happens is a person that's drowning tries to beat on the one that's trying to help them to make them drown. So they can say, you see, it's not me that's drowning, it's you. It's you. I don't need help. You're the one that needs help. It's kind of like that, right? Look, you're the one that needs help, not me. As if magically that means they're not drowning. So you have to be very careful when you're helping someone that's drowning. You throw them a flotation device, say, here, grab it. You know, you don't use yourself as a flotation device, they're liable to drown you. Because in their mind they're saying, someone's drowning, oh my God, someone's drowning. And here's somebody else, oh, it must be them, it must be them, it must be them. And then they say, oh, I gotta, you know, make it look like they're drowning so I can believe it better. Yeah, dissociation. So people of this world, the help they want is to be, is to get rid of help, is to see that you cannot help them. And then they say, oh, whew, wow, I get to keep my hallucination. I get to keep myself, my identity. My fake identity. Nobody can help me get rid of it. Nobody can help me get rid of it. And they feel like empowered. See, that is a great empowerment. So the world is going towards this great empowerment, self-empowerment, false self-empowerment. Hey, they'll say, hey, nobody can help us. Well, of course, this world is going to be quarantined, of course, in which they'll say, great. You know, nobody can get through to us. But, you know, it's not entirely quarantined. We can still get through in various ways, but they want to be quarantined. They want to be quarantined, absolutely. They want to be able to say, there is no help for us, there is no God, there is no help for us whatsoever. And they say, that's great. See, nobody can help us. Finally, we're free of help. Therefore, we can keep our false identity, and we just got to figure out how to be happy with that now. And then, of course, they project and say, well, someone somewhere is trying to help us and is capable, so we don't want that. So we just got to keep working on getting rid of help. And then when we do that, we'll automatically be happy. So happiness then becomes a goal to be pursued of defending yourself from help. And since there's always this always unhappiness arising within with this instability of false identity, it's always projected into feeling like somewhere out there, somewhere, somebody's trying to help me and I gotta stop this. And of course they pretend like, well, they come, can somebody please help me? Can somebody please help me? I need help. And they go around and, please, I need help, everybody. They get themselves sick, they destitute and everything. Please, I need help. And they're really trying to locate who is that one who can help me so I can render them incapable of helping me so I can actually be happy then. This is actually what goes on here. And truth be told, it's very possible that all our so-called vulnerability and destitution and everything like that is merely our play to try and lure the helpers out of their hiding. We think they're hiding somewhere, you know, and we can lure them out and we say, aha, gotcha. So you're the one who can help me, huh? Who's able to help me. I'm going to make sure that you cannot help me. Now, that's pretty good news, isn't it? Because seeing this, we can see the basis of our sickness, our infirmity, our vulnerability, all this. It's just a lure we're using, actually. The body is just like a lure, a fishing lure, trying to find that fish, that helper fish, so we can reel in, pull it out of the water, and cook it. And if we realize we don't need to do that, because we're not scared of help, we ourselves don't need to lure any help in this way, so we don't need any troubles at all. We can be completely untroubled. And saying, literally, I don't even need any help, because I know I'm not scared of help. I'm not trying to destroy help. So I feel help's everywhere. So this is, you know, very profound, very applicable to our situation. when we begin to look at it this way, we just look at the world a different way. Hey, wait a minute. Maybe there's a very different explanation for what's going on here, and there certainly is. And then that doesn't really bind you to this world, does it? This world is just used as a lure, to try to lure hidden help out in the open so it can be destroyed. So then we can magically believe that we can therefore now be happy because nobody's going to lure us into letting go of our false identity, you see? The world looks like a different situation. It looks like a self-imposed prison experience, doesn't it? It looks very much like a self-imposed prison experience, self-imposed suffering. It looks very much like self-imposed suffering. It looks very, very much like self-imposed suffering. All for what we think is a great cause, our happiness. But it doesn't work, our happiness. We believe our happiness is to cling to our false identity with no way of ever being divested of it, you see. So self-imposed prison, self-imposed suffering here. Give up that self-imposed suffering, self-imposed imprisonment. I'm not frightened of hell. I'm not frightened of letting go of my false identity, the stance, hallucinatory stance. Why do we need then to impose any imprisonment, impose any suffering upon ourselves? We don't. We don't. Pretty amazing. Very amazing. This is very encouraging to get to this clarity here. Very encouraging. And so, full stop in that. Full stop in that. Don't struggle with the success. Acknowledge I have a severe continuity problem. That's in play still also. So be humble with the clarity. Be humble with the clarity. This is extreme clarity, but just be humble with the clarity. This is just generalizing all over the place, just expanding and generalizing. It's like, wow, this really takes it all in, doesn't it? It's a new paradigm, it's a paradigm shift. So just, okay, that's fine. Paradigm shift, good. Just be humble with it. Don't struggle with the words. Don't try to recall the insight. It's arrived. It's arrived. So now we're just stay in. In the moment. Experiencing the reaction of the arrival of this clarity. Know the import of it. The import is vast, actually. So we just say, okay, something that of vast import has now arrived. Okay, good. Don't calculate. Don't analyze. Don't try. Don't seek. Don't meditate. Don't repress. Don't contrive. Seek it. So this is a good stopping point. And we'll just see how the clarity continues to be. That's all. I'm not trying to grasp anything here. Just let the evaporation keep continuing. That's it. All right. Very great. That is it.